Good morning. Thank you for stopping by and welcome to A Crafter's Story. It's Celeste here. I love eco-dyeing. I think I've done that a couple of times on this channel. Not that often, a few times, but this is something totally new, something I've been trying, and I think I'm at a point now where I feel confident after making a few that I can share it with you. So here are a couple of examples, and then I'll show you one that is almost that is dry that I can also show as an example, and then we can do one together. So it's just watercolor, some leaves, and some watercolor paper. That is all that you're going to need to do this craft. And any kind of really inexpensive watercolor is definitely what you want to use. So I just I'm a little in awe of, oh, there's a bit of a leaf stuck there still, in awe of this method, because it's just everyone is unique. Oh, and you need leaves, of course, so you'll need to go and do a little foraging, get a couple of leaves. And the type of leaves that you use is going to make a difference. The ferns are great. I think these are maples, these are ferns. I am not good with naming leaves and plants, so I'm probably going to just stop there. If you guys know what that is, please feel free to let me know in the comments. So here's one that still has its leaves on. I'm gonna go, maybe can I go a little, yeah, maybe I can go just a little closer and you can see just a tiny bit while I can still fit everything. The leaves on here have been sitting on the paper for overnight, and any of these round marks that you see are just where I put paint bottles and my alcohol ink bottles down to keep the leaves touching the paper. Otherwise they may lift. This one's lifted, but I held it down as well with two bottles. So hopefully that there is going to be a print there. So I'm going to pull these leaves off with you, and you can see the effect, and then we can do this together. The trick that I found with the leaves is that thinner leaves without a waxy coating is going to work much better than a stiffer leaf that is that doesn't want to lie flat. So you need a leaf that will lie flat. This one almost, otherwise you're going to get some bubbling, and sometimes they won't work. But these, I have no idea what this is. I'm horrible. I should have probably researched it beforehand to see what that is. Maybe I can do a Google image search. These are my absolute favorite because they never disappoint. They always come out beautifully. I think this is a maple. Please correct me if I'm wrong. They also work really, really well. This is a, this leaf, you can't see it now, but it's purpley black, the color. Also, they came out really well. I think this is an oak. It's a little stiffer. So you'll see the stiffer ones don't work quite as well. That one didn't adhere to the paper enough, so it didn't come out as well either. So just tricks of the trade, or tricks of the craft, should I say. Find leaves that are, will lie flat, that are a little thinner, or maybe that are really stiff like this and are already flat themselves. That will work well. I'm not, you know, this one turned out quite nice. Oh, this one's gonna tear. That's okay. Another tip I have for you is, wow, this one's really sticking. I'd have to just scrape it off. I must admit, this has never happened before. I'll go and scrape that one off. It's fine. I'll get my little toothbrush out. it's not here. I don't think I have a toothbrush in my craft room, so I'll go get one and maybe just clean that off. But otherwise, the others came off really well. So there you go. Now, the trick that I have found works really well, if you go out and you forage for leaves and you aren't ready to start printing straight away, put your leaves in a Ziploc bag and in the freezer. It'll preserve the leaves, they'll stay fresh, and it's kind of like a florist who puts their flowers in the in a big cold room. Same idea, it'll keep them fresh and they won't dry out. This one obviously was drying. Oh, there, it's coming off. All right, it's not too bad, it's coming off, but I'll get my toothbrush out and get it done properly. I don't want all my paint is coming off, and that's not good. Okay, let me get us ready and we'll do one together. Right, so I'm set up. I have a protective plastic sheet. I have some watercolor paper. I went and got my leaves out of the freezer. I collected a few of these earlier this week. Some are ones that I've already used. These are new from yesterday. And I have my watercolors. Now, as far as the watercolor goes, I use a lot. And so I don't buy expensive watercolors. I'll just get those in the little tubes that usually come in a 10-pack and then put it into one of my little container. If you don't have a container like this, you can always go to the dollar store or your grocery store and buy one of those Monday to Sunday pull tablet organizers. They work just as well as this, and they have lids and you can close them. So that'll work to put your colors into. I have some water, and yeah, so let's get started. I did manage to get most of the leaf off this one that was giving me a bit of trouble. I had to get my little toothbrush out, but it worked quite well. Am I showing it to you? Yep, there we go. It worked quite well. So that is done. I'm going to put those papers off to the side. Now, I like to wet my paper first. I don't tape it down because I don't want tape marks. So I kind of work with a curling paper because of the water that goes down. It's okay. I just work with it. Got a bit of water down. I'm going to spread that all over the place and then start putting down some color. So I put down a base color and then I put the leaves down and then I add some more color. So I have a lot of the blue and yellow. Just trying to think, maybe I should do more of a like a purpley one, purple and red, purple, red and orange, something like that. So this is just our base layer, and as you can see, there's no rhyme or reason for what I'm doing. I'm just getting color down so that there's color under the leaves and I have as little white space as possible. Maybe I'll do green. This could look nice. Purple, blue and green. I don't think I've got one of those. That could be really nice. I did try this method with acrylic paint, and I watered my acrylic paint really watered it down, and it worked. It really did. I felt maybe it's just because it's very, very sort of chalky paint that I was using. Maybe a slightly more water-based acrylic paint would have been better. It just dried a little dull for my liking, and so I went back to using the watercolors for this method. I just felt that it worked better. So try different paints, see what you think, see what you feel like you can get away with. And I started. Oh, I must go look for them. When this is drying, I'll because it's got to dry overnight. So this is a video that I'm going to have to do over 2 days. I'll go and look for my little minis that I made. They're off to the side here somewhere. And I will show you. So, okay, let's start. Oh, let me throw some of these leaves out just on the counter here next to me. I like the idea of leaves that have a lot of veining like this, because my hope is always that I'm going to get that veining transferred as a print. So you see now that one's curling, which is a little bit of an issue. So I wonder if I do it that way. Let's try it that way. A little bit of a long leaf. This is that purpley color one that I told you. You couldn't see it was purple earlier because there was so much paint on it. I'm going to use this one again. Just in the corner there. Let's get that into the corner. Here's a nice little floppy leaf. This is really, I think, these are the best because the floppier, look how floppy it is. They're the best because they're going to really stick. And that's absolutely what you want. Maybe if I do it this way, I'll get more veining. That one as well. Oh, there's another. So I'll get that down, maybe in the opposite direction. So everything's, don't have everything in the same direction. Let's see this one. Let's see if it'll lie down if I put it down with the veining down. Yep, I think so. That'll work. Okay, this little guy, or that is, yeah, you can see that's a little bit of a problem. Let me see if I can find something else. Maybe I can get this one in here like that. Let's see, what else do I have here? Maybe if I move this one up a bit. And nothing's cast in stone at this point, guys, because everything's still wet, nothing's dried, nothing's going to make a permanent print. So you can play around a little bit at this stage of your design. This one has holes in it, which is kind of cool. I wonder if it'll stay. I think it might stay down. Oh, that might be nice with the little holes in it. Let's see some of my older ones. And if you put your leaves straight back into the deep freeze, into the freezer, after you take them off, I've used some of these leaves up to 3 times. It does depend on the leaf. These guys are just, I think this might be 4th, 5th, 6th time that I've used these. I have some bigger pieces. They just don't seem to die or wilt or go brittle like the other leaves do. So it's definitely, they're a winner for sure. And you can always have a couple of leaves that kind of sit off to the side, just off the page there, just to fill a gap. And I think that might be it. That is looking good. So now I'm gonna get a smaller brush. Oh, sorry, same brush. And I'm going to go around each, and this is the part that actually takes a bit longer. You're going to go around each of your leaves and saturate the area around the leaf, because that is your trace image. When you lift the leaf up, I hope to have some imprint underneath. So maybe, oh come on, maybe add a little color underneath, and then color around the side. And you can mix and match here with some color, really darken. So I have lighter green underneath and a darker blue around the sides. That looks really good. Okay, let's see, let me get some red out for here now. What do I have underneath? Like a purple. and then maybe a red. And just be careful that you don't mix too many colors. It can muddy. It can get a little muddy looking. I'm going to work from one end to the next, and which is just a preference. You don't have to do that. Get some really into those little holes there, because I think that could be kind of cute. I'm going to have to put some... Oh. All right, so I'm going to have a piece of this leaf that's going to fold, and that's just how it's going to be with that. Not much I can do about it. See, maybe if I add a little orange on the side. I don't want to add yellow to this one, so I'm going to try and stick with blues, reds, and greens. My water in this water is getting a little too muggy. Oh, let me change to some new water. And let's see. Oh, get as much paint on this brush as I can. There we go. And you know, you can always put down some color, wait a little bit, come back and put another layer down, and really get some vibrant colors on your page. I've left mine a little more muted because I'm going to use these pages as tags, as part of a journal, and they're probably going to have a few stickers over them. So I'm not being super, super fussy about the vibrancy of the color. I have a few examples that are more vibrant. So, you know, just whatever you feel like. It's kind of an in the moment thing. Let's see. A little bit of orange. Really brighten up that orange there. And this is the part that does take a little longer, does take a bit of time, but to me it's the fun part. I like it. Let's see. I think that's going to look really nice with the reds and the purples and the greens and the blues. What's next? I think let's put a bit of orange around this one. Just like that. Okay, and then this little guy, what should we do? Maybe with this lighter blue. Like that. This little one I think is going to give me a little bit of a hassle, doesn't want to lie flat. I have little bottles. I wonder if I should do it the other way, if it's going to be better if I lie down. Yeah, it still wants to pop around. Okay, we'll just commit to it lying this way. And I will get some little bottles out of my alcohol inks, because they're small bottles. It'll fit this leaf. And I'll be able to force it to stay down. All right. Oh, we're halfway already. It's going quite quick. It's good. All right. Just like that. What am I doing? I'm add a little purple at the top. It's coming with a bit of red here. Oh, nice. Look at that. Very nice. I think this one's going to be a nice one. Nice and bright. I think of it almost as a kind of tie-dye effect in a way. I don't know if you guys see what I'm seeing. It's just makes me think of tie-dye when I'm doing this. Add a bit of orange. Let's brighten the orange there a little. Let's brighten this up on the sides. And it's moving. Don't move. Stop moving. All right, now this guy, I'm going to do quite a bit, I think, of the blues and greens. So let me start with the blue. It's really pretty aqua blue. And I try to saturate it a little bit because it always leaves such a beautiful print. And see, I'll sneak in a little bit of purple and then let's add green to this side. I want to add quite a lot of green. There we go. Like that. Oh gosh, that's going to be pretty, hey? Alright, let's see. This guy that's kind of sitting off. This is why I always have paint under my nails. Because I'm always doing stuff like this. And it's a little embarrassing when I go out and I have to hide my hands. I don't mind. I'm having fun. Oh, this little guy's really gonna be a pain in the... Well, let's just say a pain. A pain in the neck. Let's say neck. We'll say neck. Neck is good. Okay, I'll see if I can get a little darker color around its side, and then if there's a lot of water under the leaf, when you put something down to weigh it down, it will squish some of that paint out and add to the print. Okay, so I think we'll go red here on this one. Pretty sure this is a maple. If I'm wrong, let me know. It wouldn't surprise me if I'm wrong. Would not surprise me if I'm wrong. I just see a leaf and I go, ooh, pretty. That's a nice shape. And then I pick it and I come home and I hope that the neighbor whose garden I took it from doesn't see me. I've been good though. I've been much better. I've been going along public roads and picking my leaves there. My son joked with me and said, I better leave my phone on because I might need to call him if I get into trouble with a neighbor. Ah, we've got lovely neighbors. It's not going to happen. All right. So I think I'm getting pretty close to getting my paint bottles out and my other little weights out to weight this down. I'm trying to get quite a bit of red on this. I think it'll look nice. Like this. Yeah, I think that's really going to come out beautifully. It's nice bright colors. I think I'll get a little extra purple down in places. A little brighter. Make the purple a bit brighter. There we go. It's a little addictive, this, because once I did one, before I knew it, I had done 10. And I thought, wait, hold on. How did I go from doing 1 to 10? But it's addictive, and it's relaxing too, you know. And I only stopped because I ran out of leaves, and then it was an excuse, of course, to grab my dad and we went for a walk and got some more leaves, and then I came back and made more. So very addictive, guys. Okay, I think I'm going to stop there. Let me get some. This is going to dry overnight, and I'm going to weigh it down with my folk art bottles, because, and also with some for these little ones, I weigh it down with, now this little guy's going to be tricky, I can see it. I might have to, let's see if I turn him around again, he'll lie down a bit better, like, okay, I think that's maybe a little better, being a little stubborn. So, just like that. And I sometimes will put these out in the sun to dry quicker, but the last couple of times I tried it, the wind blew them away. And I was mad as anything the other day because it blew it right away and destroyed it. I had to start over, so that was not cool. That was not okay. I was very sad about that, but it's okay. Alright, let's see if I can squeeze a little bottle in there. Those guys... one on there. This one probably doesn't need it, but I put one down anyway. How am I doing? I think I'm doing okay. So, oh, one here. Just one here. Alright. I'm going to leave this now. It's going to dry overnight. And tomorrow morning I'll come back and we can take everything off like I did with the other one at the beginning of the video. And we'll see. We'll see how it turns out. Good morning everybody, it's the next morning and I'm ready now to take my weights in the form of little paint bottles off my leaves and then to pull the leaves off to see what print we got. In the meantime, earlier in the video yesterday I mentioned that I started small and I did find these little guys. So this could actually look like one of the big ones that I cut up, but it was actually a small one. So these little ones come out really nicely too because they could be tags or artist's trading cards or journaling cards. This is the very, very first one I ever made. It's still definitely one of my favorites. And you can see how, you know, on the sides you can add little words and things where you can really spruce this up. This is one of those fir pines that always works really well, and then that one, and then I'll show you one more before we pull these leaves off. It's this one. So once you are done, sorry I'm a little zoomed in, but once you're done and you fold these pages in half, they can become either journal covers or part of a signature. Obviously I'll have to do something on the inside, but yeah, so there is that one. So let's get these weights off here. Now this is the part where I'm going to be a little careful. I'm going to try not to break the leaves if possible to see if I can use them again, and if they break, then you know, then that is just how it goes. This one is broken, so it's fine. It just means that I have to go and steal more leaves down the road somewhere. Think that we're going to get some really nice prints, at least I hope so, because this is the one that I did with you guys, so I want it to be a good one with good prints, but you never know. And so I'm gonna have to just see if it works. Let's see. Last one. Okay, now I could use a tweezer, but I put it away like a silly person, so I'm just gonna pull this off, and if some of them stick like we had previous, you can always use your toothbrush. Nice, look at that, very nice. Oh my gosh, oh I think this one is, it's gonna be a goodie. Gonna be a goodie. Oh, ha! I get so excited. These thinner, more floppy leaves are absolutely, I know I mentioned this earlier, but they are absolutely the best. They give you beautiful prints. These two are testament to that. No, didn't make enough contact there, but that's okay. Not here neither, but there seems to have been color underneath. There wasn't enough color under there. That's okay. And I don't worry about it because, you know, I can always cover this or maybe put a little word or flower or something over it. So I don't ever worry too much. This is gorgeous. Just incredible. Makes my little craft heart so happy. Oh, just look at that. Lovely. Beautiful. I think this one is definitely a success, you guys. Again, a very, very floppy leaf and a great print. Just seems to be the winning formula. Oh, that's got nice gritty. That really shows up the veining nicely on that one. This is the one that had the little holes in it. See if they came out. I think they did. Oh, this leaf is tearing. But they did come out nicely, but I've got bits of leaf here. Let's see if I can get it all off. Almost felt a bit wet, which can't be. I mean, it's been sitting all overnight, but then again, it was under a weight, so it's possible. Oh, some of these are breaking. It's okay. I was hoping to reuse some of them, but it's fine. All right, let's do a flyby. See, I think it was a success, you guys. Definitely think this one worked beautifully, and it's gonna make a really, I'm thinking of signatures. I don't know, maybe if I made a very, very small, very thin journal, I could possibly get away with using it as a cover, but I think it's probably going to be a journal page. And in some of them, if I feel like it, there's spots that I don't like, I can always cut them up, make belly bands, make journal cards, make tags, so much I could do. So there's that one. I'll do a quick run by of the others. Is this one just a quick look. This is a very different coloring, and I really like it. It's just different. I also love the blues and the greens, but then anything blue and I love it. Blue's my favorite color. So just whilst and then this one. Oh my gosh, just, it's like a sunrise. Gorgeous. And kaleidoscope. All right, so I hope this is something, if you want to just start, maybe start small, or maybe start with a half fold, or you know what, if you just think, I'm gonna go for it, go for a full page, go for it, try it. It's dirt easy, super satisfying, and gorgeous. So if you enjoyed this video, please give me a big thumbs up. And I'll see you in the next video. Bye.